Anyway, thanks everybody for being here today. We're excited to welcome our new women's basketball coach, Amanda Butler. We had a very positive and successful search process with many outstanding candidates, which speaks to the continued power of the PAW and the brand of this great university. Amanda's 12 years as a head coach, including 10 at the University of Florida, were distinguishing factors in our decision to bring her on board, as were her 10 postseason appearances in those 12 years. She had also coached 2 years at the University of North Carolina, Charlotte. But more important than those on-the-court successes were her passion for coaching and learning. I would encourage all of you to take the time to read Amanda's blog that she wrote for the WBCA, which recaps her year away from coaching. It shows the resolve to use the time after a disappointment to grow and to prepare for what's next. It's a great trait for all of us to understand and learn, and we're excited to be the what's next for Amanda and her family. Please join me in welcoming the 7th head coach in Clemson women's basketball history, Amanda Butler.
Wow, this is awesome. Really appreciate all you guys being here. Appreciate that introduction. And I hope that you guys will all show up again with your cameras and excitement and anticipation when the season starts. We're going to need you back here. I believe, as Dan mentioned, in the power of gratitude, and I believe that gratitude is a power. And sometimes you have to fight to find gratitude in certain moments. This is definitely not one of those moments because I'm very overwhelmed with all the people that I would love to stand up here and thank, but definitely very grateful for Dan Radakovich, Stephanie Ellison Johnson, and their confidence in me, along with Dr. Clements and the board, to lead this great program, to join this awesome university, and become a member of this community. We're really, really excited to join the Clemson family. And there's many people that I would love to stand up here and thank, but I also want to get to a point where I can answer your questions. But I do specifically want to acknowledge all the people who have been part of the journey of bringing me here, the people who spent time sharing their passion for Clemson, giving me their insights into why this university is so fantastic and why right now is such a special time in Clemson's history, and looking forward into Clemson's future. So there's a few of those folks here. Michaela, I appreciate you very much. Caitlin back there, our strength coach. A lot of folks that it was very easy to see why this place was so special. And I tell you what, I got here as fast as I possibly could. They made it very obvious to me. I want to also thank all of you guys for being here, and this being such a memorable day for me and my family. And there we go. This is my little boy, Nehemiah. I want my family and friends who came today, stand up. Let everybody see. They've got to know. We travel in a pack, and I'm very proud to be theirs. And we are all very excited to be joining the Clemson family. The very first time I ever came to Clemson, it was when I was in high school. Wasn't that long ago, but it was a bit ago, and I do the math, you can figure it out. We came for an exposure event. I was a high school basketball player. It was Shep Levine's All-Star Camp, which was a very unique event back in the day. And the thing I remember the most about that was not the competition, not the long drive from Mount Juliet, Tennessee. It was those big orange paw prints on the street. And everybody who is sitting here knows what I'm talking about. We were taking pictures in the middle of the big orange paw print at the airport when we got here last night. I've got a paw now, so I feel the power of the paw. But at that time, as a very young person, I was amazed. I'd never seen anything like that, but I knew it was an indication of, like, this place is special. This is neat. Something cool is about to happen for me, and it did. It was a great weekend, and that feeling is so real and so attainable, because on my latest visit to Clemson, I had that exact same feeling as Stephanie was driving me onto campus and I saw those big paws again. Wow, like this is just as cool as it was when I was 16 years old, but now I just understand it more. I understand the uniqueness. I understand how special and memorable this opportunity is. And so it was really thrilling and not lost on me at all, the power of the paw. There's always a process that's involved when you're hiring, and obviously the folks that I'm very thankful for choosing me know that, but also in selecting a job, and there's definitely time that has to pass by to make sure that you get it right. I want to make sure that all you guys know, as soon as this opportunity presented itself to me, I knew I wanted to be here. I knew that this was the right place for me and my family and our future and all of the opportunity that this place represents with what I believe that I can bring to the table and the ways that we can advance the program and the ways that Clemson women's basketball fans, especially of old, are used to. And that's what one of our challenges are. When I was choosing where to go next, as Dan referred to, there were two things that were really important to me. The first one was I wanted to be well-led. And the second one was I want to be somewhere where basketball, women's basketball, will be very important. And it did not take very long on my interview here to realize that both of those things are 100% true. They were feelings, and then they were proven in the conversations and the time that I got to spend with the people who make the culture here on this campus, not just in athletics, but across the university, alive. And I knew it was something that I wanted to be part of. So that is something that I wish that you guys, for just a second, would help me acknowledge, because it's pretty special and it doesn't exist everywhere. You know, as Dan mentioned, I spent a year that was truly amazing and very enriching for me personally, professionally. I had a chance to learn from some of the top organizations in the country, sports organizations, tremendous leaders, tremendous followers, just outstanding individuals. And it was so fortifying and it was so enriching. But one of the biggest blessings of that experience, besides the actual knowledge and experience, was that every day I was reminded how much I love basketball, how much I love coaching, and how much I cherish being part of a team. And then for that to be followed with God directing my path to Clemson, where those loves can be fulfilled, and then also where my passion and my enthusiasm for being part of a young woman's journey in such a critical and impactful part of her life can be met, I couldn't have dreamed of a better combination. I could not have dreamed of a better way for this year to culminate in a new beginning of something that I think is going to be very significant and very special. Those are all great thoughts and things about me that I want to share with you. However, we also need to keep the main thing the main thing. Some of the main things are here. And so I want to acknowledge the whole reason why facilities like this, why amazing academic support building and tremendous amounts of people and energy and money are committed to athletic departments, and that's because of our student athletes. And some of the young women that I got to meet this morning, I got to watch them work, and I'm gonna tell you what, I enjoyed it. I like what I saw. I was encouraged, I was inspired. I had to restrain myself to not jump in, and because I really just kind of wanted to observe and let them do their thing. And then we had a chance to talk this morning about the future, about how we're going to begin, about where we want to go, and what that's going to look like. And I'm going to tell you, it was a true pleasure. There are tremendous young women in this program, and I want them, their families, and everybody here, and everybody who's listening to know how excited I am to be part of their journey. And I consider it an honor and a privilege, and we're going to get a lot of things done. So I also would like for just a second to acknowledge them. So you guys wave back there. Because that is the main thing. To give you a little bit of insight into some of the things that we talked about, we're first, our immediate needs are, we've got to establish some trust. We've got to build a relationship. I want to know them as people. We know they're good basketball players. That's why they're here at this institution and competing in this fine conference. The second thing that we've got to do is agree for how hard we're going to work for each other. So that's what we spent a lot of time talking about today. I made it very clear to them that I'm intense and I'm demanding, but in ways that I think that they're going to enjoy because they're going to see the fruits of their labor. And I plan on every single day challenging them with something to do that day that will be their very, very best. And on some days that may be conquering a new skill. On other days that may be preparation for an exam. On other days that might be completing a tough workout of Coach C's. And in other days that might be serving to the best of their ability, their maximum capacity in this community that supports this university and this athletic program, and this particular women's basketball team with such passion and pride. We will definitely be making an impact in that regard. That's very, very important to me. A couple of the other things that we talked about that I think you want to know is that we are going to strive to be the most confident and the most aggressive team on the floor every single night. I believe that we are going to be a unit that embodies toughness, because I believe toughness is a great equalizer. I believe that you're not always the fastest or the strongest or the most experienced, but you definitely can be the more confident, the more aggressive, and the toughest unit on the floor, and we will work towards that for sure. We're going to be a family of people that pursues impact. That will be our daily directive as well. We want to make an impact not only within our team and on the court, but at our university, in our community, in our state, and eventually on the national landscape of women's basketball. That will be our directive, to be impactful in everything that we possibly can. The other part of getting this thing up and running is putting together a group of people that I can work alongside with, that understand what it's going to take for us to be successful and go to some new levels here at Clemson. And so we're assembling a staff right now of well-rounded, high-character people that are relationship-oriented and value the opportunity to be part of someone's life at such a critical juncture of their life, that understand how important it is to develop people in what we do. Skills definitely are part of that, but also getting them ready for what's next in their lives once they leave here with that diploma. The other area that special group of people that I'll eventually be able to call my staff are going to have to do is, we're going to have to guard our yard, guys. We've got to keep the best players in this area at this university. Something that's not going to be easy, but it is definitely something that's going to be part of our pursuit, and it'll be well worth the energy invested. I believe for us that small wins are going to lead to big wins. And so we're going to pursue, fight for, and celebrate those small wins that are going to lead us to the big wins that we all want to experience. One of my favorite scriptures is Galatians 6:9. And if you get a chance to read the journey this past year, there's reference to that in that article. But it begins with, "Do not grow weary in doing good." And that's another thing that we're going to pursue as we climb, as we work, as we evolve as a program. We're going to do the right thing with the faith and confidence that the right things are eventually going to happen. That goes for on and off the court. As a former student athlete who loves her university dearly, and I owe a tremendous debt of gratitude to the University of Florida and all that they have given me as a student athlete and then as a professional. But as a student athlete in particular, I also want to invite all the former Tigers to join us in this pursuit, to join us where we're at right now, and to help us, to come and encourage us and share your stories and be part of what's going to happen here. Inform us with your wisdom and all of your experiences while you were on this great campus. There are so many people that experienced the 80s and the 90s and the early 2000s of women's basketball at Clemson, where they have expectations of us going back there, but we need your help. And so this would be your personal invitation, former Tigers, to join us. We want you with us. We want you to help us. And that also goes for our fans, for our community. We know as people, I think, as adults certainly, that nothing great is ever accomplished without enthusiasm or alone. And we have big goals. We have big dreams. We want to impact that national landscape of women's basketball eventually. We cannot do that alone. We're going to need a lot of help, a lot of encouragement, a lot of support, people helping us make this an environment right here that ACC teams do not want to come into. That's going to require a lot of work on our part, but it is going to require a partnership as well with folks who can help us sell tickets and make Little John one of the most feared places to compete in. We're going to play a style that's fast, and I think it's going to be fun. We're going to play defense with passion and energy, and we're going to use the entire court to create an identity that I think that our returning fans are going to enjoy and is going to get some new fans through the door and is going to bring future Tigers into this building. We're going to pursue winners. We're going to pursue overachievers. We're going to pursue people who academically understand what a Clemson degree means for them and their future, and that they want the best of those worlds to compete at this level, at this university, in this conference, a national championship level conference, and to get a degree that has the same impact out in the world when your basketball career ends. Very, very excited to begin that journey. So I appreciate everybody being here, and I want to wrap this up in the same way that I started it. Thank you for picking me. Thank you for being here. Thank you to Dr. Clements for his approval as well of me being the next coach. We're going to continue to work as hard as we possibly can, and as much as I want to spend time here today answering questions and getting to know y'all, I've also got a little bit of work to do. And so I want to get to that as soon as I possibly can. But this is a great privilege for me. It's a great honor for me and my family. I cannot even tell you how excited I am. All I'll say right now is go Tigers. If anybody has any questions, I would love to answer them. Thank you. You know, I was really impacted, especially by those coaches that are at the highest level who allowed me into their locker rooms and into their organizations, by their levels of self-awareness and just really a very, if I could describe it this way, raw sincerity about the way they communicated with people, a thoughtfulness in the way that they led that was super impactful. And, you know, you feel like maybe you're doing some of those things as a leader, and then you see it on someone else and you go, man, I can get better. That's an area that, you know, that's kind of what I want leadership to look like on me. You know, and then the other thing was, I think, just a tireless work ethic. You know, a tireless work ethic of understanding how to be efficient with your time, but also maximize your time. Because, as I mentioned, we compete in the best women's basketball conference in the country. Everybody's working hard. We've got to find ways to work harder. It's a beautiful facility. I'm glad you said that. I was really, when I came in on my interview and had my tour, just blown away. You know, there's this building, which was built and constructed and planned for just basketball, amazing, absolutely amazing. From the locker room space to obviously where we get to compete. And I love that our setup right now is for graduation, you know, as a reminder of, you know, some of the things that are in your future, because I think that's really important to tie those two things together. But facilities here are second to none, from academics and the academic support to student life and dorms. But this building right here is jackpot. Well, I, you know, I mentioned earlier the small wins. We're going to chase and fight for those small wins every single day. And, you know, I think success is a very vague term, but we're going to have success early. You know, will that mean X amount of wins or, you know, this, that, or the other? That's really hard to define at this point. But small wins, we're going to rack up a lot of those as quickly as we possibly can.
Yes.
You know, I was given a tremendous opportunity at Florida, and when I began there as the head coach, the program was in a similar position as this one is, and that hadn't won quite as many games as they had hoped to and wanted to return to postseason. And so I learned a lot of really valuable lessons through that process. Certainly, some of those lessons I got it right, and some of those lessons I get a chance to do it over and do it better than I did the second time. But I think coaching and competing in the SEC is great preparation for how this league is as well, which is very, very unforgiving. And at the same time, on the recruiting trail, you get a chance to go out and find people who want to be somewhere where they're going to be challenged every single day. There's never a, hey, well, this is in the a W we can go ahead and put in the win comp. That doesn't exist in the ACC. So those challenges and those opportunities, I think I've experienced to a certain degree already, and I will definitely have a lot of carryover in that regard. I do have a relationship with Dawn, and I tell you, I have a tremendous amount of respect for her and what she's done there, and I think the biggest asset for us is that program has shone a light on our state. That success at the highest level in women's basketball can occur right here. I think it's a fantastic rivalry, and I love those rivalries. That's what makes college sport special. We certainly know we have a lot of work to do. We've got some catching up to do. And, we talked about work ethic. We've talked about a lot of different things today. But, we're excited for those battles that we're going to have with South Carolina.
Any other questions? Thanks, Coach.
All right.